lighting. So first I will try to give a quick overview of force record data. Now already we had a quick overview of the force record data. This is used to refer to the record, force record data. Whenever we have has record ID, based on the has record ID, it is going to get the data, display the data based on the force has record ID. What is the purpose of that has record ID? It will ensure that the ID of the record, okay, ID of the record is passed in the URL. In the URL, whatever the ID of the record you have given, that ID of the record is taken and passed to the component. Has record ID is interface. Now it has got majorly four attributes. One is record ID. ID of the record it is trying to refer. Suppose it is a new record. If it is a new record, first I have to refer to the instance of a record. Unless I create an instance of the record, I cannot do, okay, use the record for. So first I want to mention ID of the record which I want to refer. Second, I want to convey target object, target record. Third one, target fields. Fourth one, target, okay, errors, record ID, target record, target fields, fields, target error, okay, record updated. These are the commonly used attribute in this one. So let us look at this one now. Specifications. What are the properties we have? Record ID. ID of the record which is inherited from the page. Target fields. If you want to refer to the record, we refer with the help of target fields. Whichever the record we are referring based on the ID, that record is given with the target fields. Target record also same, but it is easy for you to refer using target fields. Target record, target fields, both are referring to the record whose ID was passed. But it is easy for us to refer to the record by using target fields. Then it is asking target error. In case while loading the record, while editing the record, in any case any error occurs, how to display, that is mentioned as target error. Layout type. Are you trying to refer to the full layout or compact layout? Next we have fields. I don't want all the fields. I want only specific fields. You can mention the fields name. Then we have mode. Is it a view mode or edit mode? By default, it will take as view mode. Now, on this, what are the actions we have? Look at the actions. Get new record, reload record, save record, delete record. These are the actions which are specified on the force record data. Force record data is like a standard controller with the, is like a visual force page with a standard controller. Now, when I say visual force with standard controller, then when I say standard controller equal to account, input text, value equal to account.name. Now we are trying to create a new record. Now I am trying to save the record. I am trying to edit the record. I am trying to delete the record. Whatever the action you are trying to perform on the VF page with the concept of standard controller in the VF page, same concept we are trying to perform in the Lightning with the help of Lightning Data Services. Whatever the concept you are trying to perform, in the Visual Force page with a standard controller, same functionality we are trying to perform in the Lightning with the help of Lightning Data Services. I hope you got my point. So in the VF page, standard controller, in the Lightning Data Services. In the VF page, when you apply standard controller, how the VF page will run? VF page will it run in the user context or system context? We have with sharing, without sharing in the Apex class, okay? But in the VF page, by default, the VF page is going to run with the user context or system context. By default, the VF page will run in whose context? User context or system context? It is going to run on user context. Every VF page will be running by default by user context. No, you want to dominate this, then you are going to define a class without sharing. When you define a class without sharing, then you are going to fetch the data, refer to the table in the form of without sharing and trying to apply in the VF page. Generally, VF page will be running in the user context. Similarly, LDS is also going to run on the concept of user context. When I apply LDS, it is also going to run internally on the concept of what? User context. So all the field level securities, will be applied on this particular LDS. Now in the LDS, refer to the point. It is used to accessing the record, modifying the record, creating the record, deleting the record. If I use a VF page, Apex page, standard control equal to account, what I can do? I can create a new record, I can save the record, I can edit the record, I can delete the record. There are standard actions, right? We already have a standard actions on every S object. Every S object has some standard action. What are those global actions that we have? Create, save, edit, delete, view. Create, edit, delete, view. Create, edit, delete, view, save. The same global actions in the Lightning LDS can be performed. Then, what is the format here? Now, if you remember, in the last session we have done Lightning record view form, Lightning edit form, then we have used Lightning record form. Instead of giving a view form or edit form, we have taken a Lightning record form which has got the mode. Mode equal to view, mode equal to edit. Both I can achieve in a single. Okay. The record form also the same. Now, look at the point here. Whenever we want to use force record data, it is a must that whenever we want to use data, we are going to apply what? Force has record ID. If we implement this, then whatever the page from where I am referring to this component, that record ID will be passed here. Now let us take a quick example. To convey the same topic. Now, if I use Lightning record form, what we are going to give? Object API. This is how we are going to use it. So, I am going to create a component, invoke the component within the application, then we want to see it. This is what we have been doing in all the examples. Create a component, call the component in the Lightning application, display it. Now I don't want to invoke the component within the application. I want to call this component from the existing page. I don't want to invoke the component within the application. I want this component to be called from the existing page. So how it can be called? Let us take an example here. I am taking here Lightning component. LDS example. Here we have an interface. What was that? Lightning record. When I say Lightning record page, we are getting a interface here. Flexi page available for record home. And we have one more interface called force has record. I was taking here URA attribute. Name equal to AGC.
Hi, Satish.
Yes, Amma.
I have a question. If I pick interface as a record page, can I change it in future to app page?
We can add it up, Amma.
Okay. And at the end of the class, can you show that?
Take an interface, modify it. What is there to modify? Do it, Amma. You add one more interface, Amma.
Okay.
put command before add it up, that's all, right?
Okay.
Attribute name equal to I have taken two ACC, new ACC. Then we have force record data, force record data, record ID. By default, has record ID. Whatever the record ID that has record ID is referring, that record is given here. Then target then we have here I can give layout type full or compact. Okay, if I don't want to refer to that, I can give it as fields equal to right. You want to mention target error, you can mention the target error. Right. Now what is the mode in which you want the record data to be opened? Mode view form. Now whichever the record on which we are adding this component, whichever the record home page I am adding this component, that record ID is taken as v dot record ID. Then whichever the record that is, okay, whichever the record ID is passed, we want to refer to that record. Which data you want to fetch? Name, industry, rating. Now I can give target record or target fields. It's not necessary to give both of them. Any one will be suitable. Target record or target fields. Similarly, layout type or fields. Any one will be sufficient. Now it is not necessary that I have to give target record and target fields. To tell you that both of them are there, I am giving you. Generally, we go with the target fields. The next again, layout type or fields. Both are trying to tell which fields we are trying to refer. Both of them are going to tell which fields we are going to refer. So again, here we are taking care. Lighting. Card, title, account.
Okay, so Satish, here you are passing data from one component to other component using force record data.
No.
So how is that different from?
No, it is not.
Okay,
let me finish it. You will see where I am adding it. Okay.
Okay.
V dot ACC dot is supposed to give formatted text. I will modify as a formatted text here. I give output text. I was supposed to modify as formatted text. I was supposed to modify this as formatted text or input text. Just thought of copy paste. Right. So I have given this. which fields I was referring? Name, industry, rating. Name, industry, rating. Now go back to the component. Go back to any one of the record. Account. This is what? Record home page. What was this? Record home page. It is a record home page. If you want to add a component, if you want to add a component on the record home page, then the component should implement an interface called flexi page available for record home. You want this component to be added in the home page of a record, then we are supposed to implement flexi page available for record home page interface. Go back to this. Then I'm taking it LDS. Example. The previous component, there is a error on the previous component which is added there. So what is the name of the component I created? This example. Okay. Then save. If you go back, now basically it's a not a text field, it is a so value label. Both of them are eclipse fields. I give formatted text. Let us move on. Check out this. So look at this. Now, how are you getting this United Oil, Gas and Singapore? The record, this is a home page of record. Whichever the record on which my component is added, that record ID is there in the URL. The record on which my component is added, for that record in the URL is a record ID. Get me the ID of the record in which I have added this. Get me the ID of the record on which I have added this component. So that ID we are going to get. That ID is taken as record ID. That record is taken as has record ID. From that has record ID, we are capturing the ID of the record, storing in record data. In the record data, what is this V dot record ID? Whichever the record on which I added this component, that record ID is positive here. Whichever the record on which I added this component, that record ID is positive here. From that record, what are the fields I gave? Name, industry, rating. That's how I put it. Are you getting my point? This is on the account I am trying to give account. But my practical requirement is not this. From the account page, I want to create a contact. From account page, I want to create a contact. From account page, I want to create an opportunity. For my code page, I want to create a task. For my code page, I want to create a order. Now to demonstrate you that same ID is getting passed here, to demonstrate you that same ID is getting passed here, to demonstrate that same ID is getting passed here, I have taken this component added on the record home page. Is that was clear? So has record ID will ensure that you are passing ID of a record. Has record ID will ensure that the URL contains ID. The URL contains ID so that I can capture that ID and pass that ID to record force record data. Is that was clear for everyone? The basic component is clear. Followed simple example pass. You have done extension concept, right? You have done extension concept in the VF page. In the extension concept, what will you do? On the existing page, you are trying to add something new. Am I right? On the detail page of a record, we are trying to add a button. We are trying to add a link. We are trying to add one more VF page in it. Am I right? On the existing record, we want to create a button. We want to create a link. We want to create an existing VF page. Then what we have done? You have given Apex page standard control equal to account extension. Now wherever the button is added, the page from where I click the button, the record from where I click the button, that record ID will be passed as a Apex pages dot standard controller in the Apex class. Is that was right or wrong? Is that was right or wrong? Whichever the record from which I am clicking on the button, that record ID is passed to that particular Apex class so that you can apply some logic. Similarly, in whichever the record I was adding this component, that record ID will be passed to this one as a record ID, has a record ID. When I add a new component to the existing record, this is not a custom page. On the record home page, on the existing record home page, I was trying to embed my custom component. When I was trying to embed my custom component, whichever the record page I am in which I am trying to embed this component, that record ID will be passed as a has record ID. That is the context. Did you follow this? Followed? Followed or not? Change your expression, sir. Right. Fine. Right. Whichever the record on which I am adding my custom component, that record ID will be passed as a has record ID. When you know the ID of the record, I can communicate. Now my requirement here is, look at my requirement. I want to create a contact here, not a record ID. I am not interested to show the record ID. I am interested to create a contact. When you are interested to create a contact, how can you create a contact record here? How can you create a contact record? So I was supposed to create a contact record. Instance of a contact record, I have to create and load it here. So how do you create an instance of a contact record? By using LDS. By using a record, force record form. Oh, sorry. Force record data. How will you create? By using force record data. By using force record data. By using force record data. How will you create instance of a new object? That is a question here. For these, we have a predefined functionality called get new record. There is a function called get new record. You can look at this. What is the function we had here? Get new record. This is the one, get a new record. There is a predefined function which was given by Salesforce to create new instance of S object from the JavaScript. If you want to create new instance of S object, if you want to create new instance of S object from the client side controller, we have a method called get new record. So when you want to create a new record, when you want to create a new record, it has the parameter get new record param 1, param 2, param 3. There are four parameters. Param 1, name of the object. Which SA object you want to refer? Record type ID. Now when you are saying account, account may have multiple record types. In the account object, I have a customer and a distributor. Now in the account object, we have two record types or three record types: personal customer, customer, personal customer, organizational customer, distributor. When you have a record type, you want to create a record with respect to a particular record type. I want to create an instance of an SA object with reference to a particular record type. Then mention ID of the record type which you want to refer. Then skip caching. Now we have a cache. Now auto population of data will be there, right? The data is stored to the cache. Then again, callback action. Now it's a callback action. So param 1, name of the object. Param 2, record type. Param 3, cache. You want to skip the cache. Param 4, callback action. When I say callback action, how will you give it? $A, get. $A, get callback. $A, get callback. You can give function get callback action. So how many parameters we have? Param 1, param 2, param 3, param 4. Object API name, record type ID, skip cache, and we have callback action. There are four things. The same data, we'll try to see. Same component, we'll try to see in terms of critical description. So creating a record. Look at the parameters what we have. We don't need all this stuff. Okay. Callback action. How will you create a callback action? $A dot get callback. $A dot get callback. $A dot get callback. $A dot get callback. So in the callback action, what will you do? I will check whether record was created or not. I will check whether record was created or not. If record was created, no problem. If record is not created, then I need to verify what is the error we have seen. If record was created, no problem. If record is not created, then I want to throw error message. I hope you got my story. So let us try to understand the basic example here. Now, what is the story here? I want to create a new instance of a record by using LDS. I want to create a new instance of a record by using LDS. On account page, I want to create a contact creation page. On the account record, I want to add a component which will help you to create a contact. Simple example, boss. Look at this. Now, what are we getting here? Component to create record. Now, I want to give the same account record. I want to give a small component using which you can create a new contact. That was my intention. Have you got the story? Followed. I want to take an account record on which I want to add one component. Using this component, what I want to do? I want to create one contact record. But this component is to create a contact. Where should I add this component? On the record, on the account record form, on the record homepage. On the account record homepage, I want to add one custom component which will help you to create new contact record. That was my intention. To do this, what is the method we have? The method name is get new record. How many parameters it require? Four parameters. First parameter, name of the S object. Second one, record type ID. In case if you are not passing any record type ID, null we can give. Third one, skip cache, we can simply say false. Okay, fourth one, callback action. How will you give? Dollar a dot get callback function. Dollar a dot get callback function. So after performing this, what is the action you want to perform? Everyone is good with this, Amma? Right. Now, somebody has asked me a question. Now, are we adding the component within another component? Did you get the answer, boss?
Yes, thanks.
Right. Now, come back to the story. Now, I am going to the lightning component. LDS. So here I was giving Eura. Now, force record data, URA ID, target record v dot new. Then I have fields. Mode edit. Now, generally, look at the story. Generally, if I add this component on the account home page, which record ID will come? If I take this component, add on the account record page, which ID will come? Account ID will come. I don't want to refer to the account record. I want to refer to the contact record. I don't want to refer to the account record. I want to refer to the contact record. So what I need to do here, I have a controller. The controller. Here I was giving component dot find, what is ID? REC. Component find REC. So referring to the record form data dot get new. This was my intention. Component dot find force record data dot get new record. Contact, first parameter, name of the object, contact, any record type, no, false, then this is what I create. Now in this, anyone has any query? In this, anyone has any query? Contact,
no.
Null, false, dollar a dot get callback function. This is what I received. Here what I was supposed to do, this has created a record, contact record. If the contact record was successfully created, then what will happen? This will not be empty. Am I right? If the contact record was created, new contact CON, contact new contact CON equal to new contact, then new contact will not be null. It will be what? Empty. It is not null. Now get this value and verify, is it null or not? If it is null, boss, record creation failed. If record was created successfully, it will not be null. Account ACC. ACC equal to null because no memory was allocated. Account ACC equal to new account. ACC is not null. Now I call this method. This method is supposed to create one contact record. If the contact record was successfully created, then new contact will not be a null. If new contact is a null, what does it mean? Contact record creation failed. Is that was clear? Am I right or wrong? I was trying to create a new contact. If the new contact was created successfully, new con will not be a null. If new con equal to null, that means contact creation failed. That means contact creation failed. That means contact creation failed. Did you get my concept? People got the concept here? Right. So let me move on. I'm going to where AC is equal to component dot if ACC equal to contact creation failed. What's that going to give? Six. I can give alert here. Down the line, line number 16. Okay. Down the line, we are going to replace. Down the line, we are going to replace this alert message with, okay, toast message. Right now, I am showing alert message. Down the line, we are going to replace with a toast message. The pop-up window message, what we are getting, in the lightning, we have a message called toast. We will try to save, on the top, we get a message, saved, error. We replace this alert message with a toast message. Okay. Now, come back to the story. We have created this component. How will you include this component? Go to the record, any one of the account record. Open the account record. Edit page. Then I was supposed to give. Now, here I want to make some changes here. Okay. First, let me create only dummy data. I'm not creating any contact form. Only I just created a pop-up message to tell whether it was created successfully or not. Now, when this is going to be loaded? When you call this function, then only contact will be created. So what I want to do, your handler name equal to init. Let me refresh. Component error has occurred. False is not defined. What was that? Invoke.
I think the spelling.
Okay. Let me check out C dot invoke. Right. Now we need to make a changes until it is refreshed properly. Now what was that? Still is not refreshed. Let's refresh the pages. The changes what I made is still not refreshed. Contact success. Then inspect the element console. Contact created successfully. So with the help of the form what I created, we are able to create a contact. How did you create a contact? Component dot find record force data, whichever the element is referring to record force data, whichever the ID referring to the record force data, refer the dot get new record, create a new record for the contact, record type null and cache false and callback action. Callback action is only to check whether record was created successfully or not. Callback action is to create only record was created successfully or not. It is not performing any action here. Okay. Once it is created successfully, what I want to do? Lightning card. Attribute. Right now, I'm not giving any action. Line number. Your asset attribute.
Satish, here we passed the account ID and we created contact.
No.
So
we didn't see account ID is coming. We didn't use it. They are giving account ID. I have not used it. Now this record data what I created. It is referring to contact. See,
but contact on what?
Contact record we are creating, boss.
We are just but what boss. Values? What is the name of first name, last name, phone?
What is the name of last name in for this?
Oh, you are just creating the instance of it. Sorry. Okay. I thought okay value also. Okay.
No, for the values we are trying to take the set here. Okay. Now,
okay, thank you.
We can have multiple record data. We can create multiple record data. We can create multiple record data, right? Now, look at this. We'll do one step by step. I'm incrementing the step by step procedures. Okay. By the time we complete all the example, the overall set will come. I'm just getting into the incremental steps. Lightning input label value equal to v dot con dot this how I have taken. So let me refresh the page again. Let me refresh the page. When I refresh the page, what is the message you are getting here? Contact, last name, first name, phone. So a component was created. On the account, we got a component which is used to create. On the account, we got a component which is used to create contact. On the account, we got a component which is used to create contact. On a component, okay, on a account record page, on the account account record page, we got a component which is used to create contact. Now, once I enter the data, when I click on the save, records should be saved. Now, basically, what is the purpose of LDS? LDS says don't interact with the Apex side, okay, server side Apex classes. Without interacting with the server side Apex classes, we want to insert the data, we want to delete the data, we want to undelete the data, okay, we want to edit the data. without interacting with the server side controllers, we want to insert the data, update the data, delete the data. That is the purpose of LDS. Now, what is the core purpose of FX space standard control equal to account? When I give standard control equal to account, without referring to any FX classes, directly I want to save the record into account, okay, edit the record in the account, delete the record in the account. Whenever we say FX page standard control equal to account, we are trying to sell to the system boss without interacting with the server side logics. I am trying to insert the data into the account object. Similarly, LDS is used to perform the DML operations on the given object without interacting with the server side controllers. Did you get the concept here? The core objective of LDS is without interacting with the server side controllers, I want to insert the record, I want to update the record, I want to delete the record. This is the core objective. Did you get my point here? Is that was clear? So LDS will try to perform the DML operation on the given object without interacting with the server side controllers. The way VF page does FX page standard control equal to account, save the record to account, delete the record from account, okay, edit the record from account. Here, without interacting with FX class, we are trying to perform the changes on the data. Here also, without interacting with the FX side controllers, I want to insert the data. Previously, we have done some example. When I click on the button, what will happen? Client side controller will call. Client side controller calling FX class. FX class inserting the data, giving the response message. Am I right? Previously, we have done the examples. The same type of examples we have done earlier. But in the earlier examples, what we have done? When I click on the button, it is calling the JavaScript. JavaScript is calling FX class. FX class is inserting the data. Response is given to the JavaScript. JavaScript is printing the response. JavaScript is giving the output to the Lightning Commons. But here, we want to bypass FX classes. Without using FX classes, I want to save the data. That's why we have the second functionality. The way we created a record, similarly, we have the next function called save record. What is the second function we have? Save record.
Satish, are we replacing the standard controllers with LDS in Lightning?
LDS is a replica of standard controller what we use in Visual Force.
Okay.
What in the classic, you are using Visual Force with a standard controller. In the Lightning, you are using component with the LDS. Right? The counterpart of the standard controller in the classic is LDS in Lightning. Right? Are you clear? We are not replacing. Standard controller will be used in VF page. There I cannot use LDS. In the Lightning, I cannot use standard controller. Here, whatever you are able to achieve with the standard controller in the VF page, same thing if you want to achieve in the Lightning, we will use LDS. They are not replaceable. Counterparts.
Yeah.
Okay, fine. Let us move on to the next story. What is the next story we had? Our story is how do you save the record? If you want to save the record, the same save record, it has one function. When you want to save the record, it has one function. Okay. Now we want to save the record. When you want to save the record, we had only one function, which is called component dot save result. Okay, component dot save record. When you save the record, you are going to get a response. When you save the record, you are going to get a response whether success or failure. Right? So what is that called? So look at the point. I'll give the counterpart here. Whatever the element, component dot find ID. Then I'm giving save record. When I say save record function, save record, when you say save record, we are going to get a response. Now what was that response? Save result. Now I am going to say, now save result will have a state. The state can be success, it can be error, it can be draft, it can be incomplete. You made an attempt to save it. When you made an attempt to save it, it may be success, it may be failure. Okay, it may be success, it may be failure. Now, how do you know whether it's success or failure? So, when you make an operation of save, we are going to get a save result. The status of the DML what you performed. When you made an attempt to save the record, what is the status of that operation? You made an attempt to save the record. When you are making an attempt to save the record, what is the status of that operation? Is it success or a failure? We will know from the save result. Now, to know what are the different states we have, look at the concept here. We have a save result. I guess we have, okay. Now, look at the process here. Success. Success, draft, incomplete, error. Now, success, draft, incomplete, error. There's a concept called work offline, right? There's a concept called work offline. So, if you enable the work offline to the user, when there is no internet connection, still the data will be saved to your local system. When the internet is connected, the changes what you made will be automatically replicated to your server. In the Salesforce, there is a concept called work offline, offline user. So, for the offline user, now I am a sales guy boss, I am a sales guy, or BDM, I keep interacting with the customer, there is no internet for me. Does it mean that I should stop my business? Okay, does it mean that I should stop my business or start interacting with the customer? No, still I should be able to catch up, pull the data, show the data, whatever the changes I made, whatever the increase I made, that should be still saved in my system. When I get an internet, they should be saved to application. To do this type of operation, we have offline user. Now, if you are offline user, you have a permission for an offline user, there is no internet connection, somehow the server is not reachable, then whatever the changes you made is still saved to your local system. When you get an internet, you will be saved to server. When you are doing on Eclipse, when you are working on Eclipse or Forge.com IDE, okay, what we do? Sometimes we save it, but it takes longer time. So they say save to local system will be reachable, will be applied to the server when internet is on. Have you tried any time on the Eclipse? If you made any attempt of working with Eclipse anytime, okay, the Salesforce, you might have encountered this. Okay, fine. Now that is called draft. That is called draft. Why I was giving, we'll be giving a status called draft. Success, saved. Draft was saved to the local system. When server is available, it will be updated to server. Incomplete was, I was trying to invoke a server, but the server was not available to me because of n number of reasons. Error, I made an attempt, but the DML failed. Error is failed. Incomplete is unable to reach your server. Draft, unable to reach your server, but I have an option to save to my local system and update back to server whenever we connect back. Success. This is what? State. This is what? State. Now, when this state will come? After I make a operation of save. When I made a save record, then record is, there is an attempt to save the record to the database. When there is an attempt to save the record to the database, that may be a success, that may be a draft, incomplete or error. So, I want to track it. I want to track it. Are you getting my point? When is this? When is this? When was this? When I was trying to save the record. When I was trying to save the record, this will come into the picture. When I was trying to save the record, this will come into the picture. So let me give you this message. I hope everybody followed this, right? Okay. Now come back to the story. Call me. What is the record data? REC. Component dot find. REC. Save. Save result. In the save result, where? State equal to if state success. Here I'll introduce one concept. First let us look at the output. I'll introduce the concept. First let us look at the output what we have, then I'll introduce the concept. Just now I told you we'll go with a toast message, right? Just now I told you we'll go with the toast message. Just let us try to look at the output here, then I'll explain you what was this. Function. Okay. First let us look at the output. I'll try to make it. Basically our operation is, this is the operation. This is your choice. Now this is to tell you whether record is saved successfully or not. That is only to tell you whether record is saved successfully or not. My operation is save record. My operation is save record. It will save the record. After saving the record, I want to know the status. Whether it is success or a failure, there is a reason I am writing a status. But what is our logic? Save record. That record dot save record. Okay. Here I am giving. So don't worry about this code. Once I show the output, I'll come back to this code again. Okay. So what we give here, action equal to on click. Okay. So go back to the story again. We need to refresh. I'm not sure like. So until the changes are, there is a reason. It is a good practice to disable the cache. When you disable the cache, the previous okay.
For save button, I think you did not define the action method.
You gave no save call.
Oh, sorry. Okay, sorry.
Right. Now, move on to this. Here.
Satish, on this page, you are defining the Lightning input variables as v.com, whereas in the record data, you are using target record as v.new record, v.target fields is v.com.
See,
so which is
target fields? Yeah. Target fields is what I am using here. Target fields is always easy to use.
Okay, it's just a list of fields for the input, whereas target record is after the record is. Something happened, see, then the
both are
full record will go.
Both are referring to the same record. But when you go
same
with
record.
The,
okay.
Okay, when you go with the target record, the way I have to refer is complex format. Now when you say target fields, it's easy to refer like v.c. field name. But whereas in the target record, there is a complex procedure. I need to give object name, types, this is a extension, right? Instead of using this, it is simplified to use this format. That is the reason always I'm using this. Okay.
Okay, thank you.
basically target record, target fields, both are referring to the same record. Okay. Now target fields is easy because always you have done a dot name, a dot phone, a dot industry. We are okay, habituated of using this. There is a reason I was always using target fields to refer my data. Okay. So come back to the story again, refresh. Let me refresh this to create.
Is there any better way of saying that we got the new code applied onto the page? Because like 5 times, 6 times, it varies how many times we need to refresh the page.
So basically, we need to disable the cache.
Okay.
This one. Okay. But the changes to be applied, there's no other option other than refreshing the page. Now you got a message there, right? What was the message you got? Saved record was saved. Previously, the same thing I was giving with the help of what? Alert. Previously, I was giving a option with the alert. Okay. So go to the contact, K Prasad. Go to the contact. See whether record was saved or not. People are not asking how you are setting the ID of the account. Now contact was created, but this contact is not created for the same account. Contact was created, but the contact was not created for the same account. Right? We are only creating a contact. It is not setting for the same, okay, same account. Then what we are supposed to do? Here we took it, right? Then here we are supposed to say acc.accountid. Whose record ID will come? V.recordID means? The record on which I added this component, that record ID is coming. That record ID we are setting to ACC dot. Then we are supposed to give. After getting a contact, for the contact account ID equal to the record ID. This is how I am setting it. Did you follow my point? Whenever a contact is created, get the ID of the account, pass that ID to acc.accountid, then put that acc back to attribute called v.acc. Did you follow this point? Did you follow this point? Okay. Now what was this new contact which was created? There is no field values. acc.lastname null, acc.firstname null, acc.accountid null. Then what did I do? What did you do? acc.accountid equal to acc.accountid equal to this is CY. acc.accountid equal to okay component.get v.recordid. When you say v.recordid, it is referring to the ID of the account on which this component is added. Right? Referring to the ID of the record, ID of the account record on which this component is added. After assigning this, again I told. Component dot set v dot con, okay, v dot con new contact or else v dot con whatever it is, okay, equal to acc. Here what is what I was supposed to give? I hope you are good with this. Okay. Right. Now this is setting the ID of the account so that when you create a record, that will be saved to the concerned account record. I hope this is clear. Right. Now come back to the story. Now we didn't, we just copy pasted this code. But this one we know state equal to success, state equal to draft. Just now we discussed. But this is the code which I copy pasted without explanation. Right. Now let me. Now you saw the, what is the response of the code, right? What is the response? It is printing a top like alert box, it is printing status, success, failure, like that. How do you create it? How do you call an event? Tell me. Equal to $a dot get application level event, dollar a dot get e dot force. C is your event, because you created an event, it is C, but I am referring to one of the standard event, because event was created by you, you gave e dot C colon, but now I am referring to one standard event. Force, so what is the message name called? Toast message. What was the event name? Show toast. Now what do you want to show? I want to set the parameter, my evt dot set params. I want to pass the parameter. How do you pass the parameters? Title, message, this is the IQ. Then this is the event, these are the attributes. What should I do? My EVT dot. Have you got the story? Okay. Now I'll copy paste the code what I used earlier. Now look at the code now. Dollar a dot e dot force colon show toast. Okay. Set params, title saved, message record was saved. Then I told result stores dot file. The same thing I can also give. Else. Failed, or I can get the message, what is the error message, I can give it. Saved means saved message, error means error message. So have you got the story? This is all the alert what you want to print. This is not our logic. Our logic is only save record. Our logic is only save record. After saving, if you want to give any alert saying that record is saved, record is not saved, then I was using this. That is also, if you want to print like a toast, I will use it. No, you want to give like a console, console.log saved, console.log failed. You want to give alert, alert record saved, alert record failed. Generally in the Lightning, we find show toast message. The Lightning generally when you save the record, what type of message we get? Toast messages. It is a toast. Okay. Right. Now, anyone has any query on this, let me know.
Okay, so Satish, the message saved successfully. I think it did pop up for.
Yeah, go ahead, continue.
Okay, so the message what you showed saved successfully, I think it came in for a very short interval. When there is an error, we want user to see that error, read it properly. So can we increase the duration of how much time it shows on the screen?
Now, time intervals, I don't think we can show the time intervals. We need to go to the console and see it. Okay.
Okay.
If it is the case, then what we are supposed to do, if it is success, show the toast message. If it is failure, show the overlay message. Overlay message means pop-up box. Previously, we got a error message, right? Pop-up box came until I closed it was displaying. Line number 21. Okay.
Yeah.
That's called overlay message. Overlay action. Okay. If it is overlay action, unless you close it, it will be there. There is a model box, overlay box, this type of messages are there. Okay. That we can.
Okay, thank you.
That we'll be using. Okay, that will be covering in short. Overlay message will be covering in short.
Right. Thank you.
Concept is clear for everyone. So now what is this? Creating a record, saving a record. Okay. What about editing the record? You want to modify and save it. Now we want to open it. The existing record we want to open it. This is purely saving a record. It has nothing to do with editing. Am I right? Because contact is not the data. Contact is not the data of the account. In the account record pair, contact was a new instance. I was saving it. Now, what is my context here? I don't want to save a new record. I want to show one of the account data, the same account data I want to modify. Whichever the account data I am taking, the account data quick view will come in the left hand side. The account data quick view I want to show in the left hand side, that data I want to modify. So to show it in the UI, look at this example. When you are looking at this example, you look at this example, this is there. This is not showing complete record, right? This is not showing complete record. I want to make some changes here. I want to make some changes here. The moment I make a changes here, click on save, record should be saved. Now this is updating the existing record, editing the existing record, trying to update the same record. I was trying to refer to one of the component which will show quick view. Now let us see, I don't want this page amount. Whatever you are finding on the top, I don't like that component. Whatever you are finding on the top, I don't like that component. There I want to replace with my component. Now you are finding this, right? I don't want this. I don't want this. I removed it. When I remove this, what is happening? When I remove there, standard contact form is not coming, right? Standard contact form is not coming. There I want to replace with my custom component. There I want to replace with my custom component. In that component, if I make any, okay, in that component, whose data is displayed? The same record data. Right. Are you able to follow? Right. Look at this.
Look so at is this. That
just come on, give me 1 second. 1 second. Now this is the page what we got. When you got this page, what was this component here? Did you define this component? No, it is not your component. I want to design my own component, replace this component with my own component. Right? Now in that case, whose data you are displaying? Whichever the record ID is there on the top, the same record will be displayed here. But whose component was that? It is my component. It is not the standard component, it is my own component. Getting my point? In that component, I gave an option to modify the data. When I modify the data and click on save, it should be updated. Because it is not a standard component, now look at this. They are not giving an option for me to modify this. Now they are not giving me option to modify this. I want to give an option to modify. I want to design my own component, allow the people to modify the data there itself. Then standard component is not doing that. I want to build my own component. When I modify and click on it, it should perform a save without interacting with FX class. Then what I require? Updating the existing record. Did you get my context? Did you get my context here? Is it was clear? Whatever the standard component it was showing, I don't want that component. I want to replace that component with my own component. There, I give an option for you to modify the data. When you modify the data, click on save, record should be saved. Now this is not creating a new record. It is updating the existing record. It is updating the existing record. Previous example, creating a new record. Right now, I am not creating, I am trying to update. Have you followed the concept? Have you followed the concept? Right? So, if you want to update, yes, someone online, someone is asking a question, go ahead. Someone is asking.
Yeah. Actually, if you want to remove the component from your page, mm-hmm. like the standard one, if you're replacing with the our custom component, mm-hmm. is that our new page or we can do the standard one?
I told you, when you are implementing a custom component, there is an interface called available for taxi page, available for record home page. The moment I use that, what will happen? No need to design a new application. Now when you say page is nothing but an application. If you say new page is nothing but an application. Now I am not creating a page. I am trying to add my custom component on the existing page. Now in the application page, we have a choice to modify and add our components and remove the existing components. When you take any standard page, on any standard page you got, if it is a record, see, okay, let me make it in this way. You have a concept of page layout, right? You have a concept of page layout. In the page layout, can I add a Visual Force page? There is an option to add a reserved force field, right? Right? You have an option to remove the fields which you want, which you don't want, add the fields which you want. You have the choice to add a related list, whatever you want to add. Similarly, in the Lightning, we call that page as app builder page. Every record page is what? App builder page. In that app builder page, what will be there? It is a collection of components. App builder page is a collection of components. It can be a standard component, it can be a custom component, or it can be a component from packages. There will be three types of components what we have. One is standard components, which are provided by the Salesforce. Second one is custom components, which are designed by you and which has FlexiPage available for all the pages, or FlexiPage available for record home page. Whichever the components which implemented this interface, those components will come to me, and also the components from package will come to me. So total how many components we are going to get? Standard, custom, manage. Now with this combination, I can shuffle anything on the page. In the application record home page, I can shuffle anything with the help of these three combinations. There's no restriction for you that only standard components should be there or only custom components should be there. You cannot remove a standard component. No such type of thing. It's the app builder. Okay. Whatever you want, you can put it. Whatever you don't want, you can remove it. Right. Are you getting my point? Just like a page layout. Just like a page layout. Now you cannot force me to use your format. I will use what my business require. Got it, ma? Everyone is good with this? Okay. Okay, let's move on to the next one. The next one was, look at the point. When I want to save the record, there is a slight change in the save record. Update the record. What was the slight change? Previously, if you want to save, what is the story I gave? My story was save record. But now it should be component dot find ID. Save record. Here we have dollar a dot get callback. So we had get callback action. There is a directly function, but here we have get callback function. There we have directly function, because it's a modification editing, we have get callback. This is one extra functionality, one extra line that we have got. Only one extra line that we have got. Dollar a dot get callback. Remaining story is same. There is no change. Only one extra line. What is the extra line? Get callback. Dollar a dot get callback. Apart from this, rest of the story is going to be same. Right? I hope you are good with this. Okay. Let me create an example. As somebody just now asked me, I'll try to implement this example. Listen here, ma. Listen carefully. In this example, I am not creating a new record. I was referring to the existing record. This is how I got. lightning cart. Then we'll try to apply phone and we had lightning or Euro set. So we had attribute actions now look at this what I was giving lightning car set the title we are getting then we got action then we got layout action we got layout then what we can do padding we can also give a padding what is the padding we can give padding small okay now look at the format component is created I am not creating any save action right now I just created one component which is having record data so record data lightning component lightning card I created with the title action and layout now go back to the contact just somebody has asked me removing the standard component so I just designed this example go to this edit page I removed the standard header was there the standard header I removed then whatever the custom page I created LDS example 3 I added here. What was that unknown token undefined or missing a token files or declaration Okay. So go back to this attribute name CON, type record data, record ID.
We need to define that CON as the object type of contact.
Yeah. Because we are referring to the existing data, it's not mandatory that we need to give it actually. Because we are referring to existing record ID, right? Okay. You know, let me check it out. 1 minute. Let me cross it. Let me cross it. What is the issue? Because we are using hash record ID, it is not necessary that we need to define it. First, let me add it up on the existing page and see. Unknown token, undefined, are you missing token file or declaration? I gave icon name standard.
I think standard spelling.
It is not necessary that it should be a contact because we are taking a data from that. Okay. The ITIL was missing. The error says icon ITD file was missing. Okay. Let me delete it. Add the component one more time. Delete this. Refresh the page first.
Satish, so we did define action method save and we call the method called show, but that method is not defined. Does it do the syntactical error?
No, it will not do. This is JavaScript, right? Only when I invoke it, it will throw error message.
Okay.
This is how I got it. So still I can give some size. I can reduce my size because it's coming as compact. I can even give the padding space. First, let me get the overall concept first. Then we'll try to modify it as per our choice. UI can be customized as per our choice down the line. Okay. So go back and take the LDS example. This is what the context is. Now what I have done, the standard page layout, I have removed it. I can apply the padding and remove it. I'll make it UI, okay, I improve the UI, but the concept is this. So what we have done in this case, whatever the standard functionality was there, I am not interested on the functionality. I removed the standard component, applied my custom component. Now if I make any changes here, then what I was trying to do? Update the record. I was trying to update the record. When I try to update the record, then I have to perform the update operation. Previously it was an insert. Now I was trying to perform update. Previously it was an insert. Now I was trying to perform an update. I have a choice. I am modifying this data, clicking on the sync. Right, boss? Clicking on the sync. Now in this case, what we are supposed to do? So here we have a show function. Go to the controller. So here what I'm going to do, component dot find save record. This is what the functionality I have given here. Now, you want to check I don't want alert. What is the other choice we have? Post message. I don't have the other choice. Okay, what is the other choice we have? Post message. Go back to the functionality. Reload the component. Now, why it was not invoked, let me give a console and see. It's not saved. Component.find, what was the record data? RECC. I give only REC. We give REC, there was given double C there. So it was not found. Right? Instead of this, what I can give? Post message. Dollar a dot get, okay, e dot colon, e dot force colon, show toast, set parameters, title message, file. Right or not? Go to the detail page and cross check whether the record is. Is it was clear? Now, if you are trying to modify the existing components, then obviously there may be a possibility of updating the record. From the same record, there is a possibility of updating the record because I removed the standard functionality, replaced with my custom functionality. Then your standard save function will not work. Then you are supposed to define the save functionality from your end. When you are replacing the standard component with your custom component, if there is a save functionality which is available on the standard component, that will not work here. We want the same save functionality to work on our custom component. Then we are supposed to define LDS service. Right? Is it was clear? Followed up? Everyone is good with this? Clear for everyone? Okay. Clear? Then again we have next delete. Now I give save, very good. But if I want to give a delete button there, because I removed the standard functionality, no. On the standard we have save, edit, create. You are able to create, very good. But now standard one you removed, you kept your own component. On your own component, I want to put a button called delete. When I click on that button called delete, record should be deleted. Previously, there is a standard functionality. When you click on new, record edit, new creation, edit, edit of the record, save, saving of the record, delete, deleting of the record. But you replace that standard component with your custom component. Then now, on the custom component, you want the same standard functionality to work. Then how will you implement? LDS. Now, why you are going for LDS? Purpose is, whatever the standard component which you are displaying, I don't like that format. I want that component to be replaced. The same thing, if you want to do it in the Visual Force page, on the classic, you told standard controller with extension, then apex pages dot standard controller, controller dot save, controller dot edit, controller dot view, controller dot list, we have some standard functionality. Similarly, whatever the standard component was there for you, I don't like the standard component. I want that to be modified according to my business requirement. When you're modifying UI, you want to modify, but the functionalities which are there in the standard component, still you want to use the same functionality. That means, still I want to use same standard functionalities which are defined by the Salesforce. Then, if you want to achieve the same standard functionalities on your custom component, then we are going with LDS services. Now, I hope you got the purpose of why we learned this. Have you got the concept? So, what is our core objective? Core objective is not LDS. Our core objective is replacing the standard component with your custom logics. When you are taking a detailed page of a record, when you are taking a record home page, on the home page, you want to replace some of the standard functionalities with your custom functionalities, but I want standard actions to be still available on the same. That is the reason I am designing a custom component with standard actions. That standard actions I was able to achieve with LDS. I hope you understood the purpose of this concept. Followed, Amma? Followed. Right. Followed. Sure. Okay. Yes.
So, Satish, what is the method which returns the...
One minute, Amma. Come again. Obviously, see, I told what I told. LDS is a counterpart of standard controller. Standard controller is used for what? Not standard object. Standard is not standard objects. Not standard object. S object. So, whatever, wherever the functionality of standard controller is used in the VF, similar functionalities are achieved in the lighting with the help of LDS. Now, once again, I repeat the point. What is your objective of, probably people are very good with Visual Force, hopefully. Now, you know, why are you going with Apex Pay with the standard controller? Why you are not using controller in the VF page? You know Apex programming. You might have done Apex classes, no? Why again you are using standard controller in the VF? Because you want the standard functionalities to be used. But UI, you don't like it. I don't like the UI. Okay. One major purpose of using standard controller is replacing existing functionalities on the corresponding S object. That was the major concept. The major concept of using standard control is when you want to replace or build any new functionality on standard pages of the concerned object, on a particular object, you want to add any new functionalities or you want to replace the existing functionalities on an object, then I go with standard controller. Then I go with the standard controller. Why you are going with standard controller in that case? Because I don't want to disturb the functionalities of that object. Whatever the object functionalities are defined by the Salesforce, still I want to use the same functionalities, but I want to modify some of the things. Whatever the standard built-in properties that are offered by the Salesforce, I want to have that, I want to enjoy that standard functionalities, but some of the custom functionalities need to be embedded. That is the reason. I want standard functionalities on the concerned object, but some of the functionalities will be customized. That is the reason you are going with the standard. That means you want to use the standard pages on the standard page of that object. Whichever the object you are using, on the standard pages of those object, some of the functionalities you want to replace, then you are going with the standard controller with extensions. Here also, when you got a lighting pages with some of the standard components, I don't want the entire page to be modified. I want entire page to be same, but few components I want to modify. I want the standard page to remain the standard page, but few components which I don't like, I want to remove it. Few things which I want to add it. But I don't want to lose the beauty of the standard functionalities. Right. Then I am going with lighting components with LDS services. I hope you got the story. Right, Amma? Right? 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 Sure? Paka? Right. Next example.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes. Somebody from online. Go ahead, Amma. What is your query?
Okay. So, in the save result, I think we should be able to show the error what we are getting if the operation is not successful, right?
Yes. You can do it.
Okay.
Okay. Right, boss? Right. Shall we go with the next concept?